Cortana, open camera.
God says that there is nothing that you can do that would make him love you more. There is also nothing you can do that would make him love you less. He loves you because he loves you, 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 because that is what he is like. It is his nature to love. And you will always be the beloved. And his love is unchanging. And he loves you 100%. He won't love you any better when you become better. He loves you 100% right now. And even if you have no plans to become better, he will still love you 100%. Because he loves you, because that's the way that he is. And even if you don't want to change, he will love you 100%. Even if you have no plans to walk with him, he will love you 100%. Because that's his nature. He loves all the way, all the time. His love is unchanging. What will change, says the Lord, is your ability to receive my love. So I challenge you, says the Lord, open your heart to me. Open your heart to me. And you will receive more of my love than you've ever experienced before. I dare you, says the Lord. Come on, open your heart to me. Give me your heart. Give me whatever your obstacle is. I'll take it. I'll remove it out of the way. Because I love you as you are right now. I love you 100% as you are right this moment. I love you as you are. So be loved. You are the beloved. It is your job, says the Lord, to be loved outrageously. It is why I chose you. That is why I set my love upon you. That you would live as one who is outrageously loved. That you would receive a radical love. So radical, it'll blow all your paradigms of what you think love is. And know, says the Lord, I will love you outrageously all the days of your life. Because I don't know how to be any different. This is who I am. And this is who I will always be. This is the I am that I promised you.
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you very much for this powerful hour. So many people rallying around everyone who needs your help, who needs your understanding, who need to understand what it is you are doing in their lives for them, Lord. Thank you very much for that powerful message. And I definitely will be praying for Toaster Oven, as well as the rest of us in this room right now, Lord. Let us all put our virtual hands over her body right now, Lord, and just pray over Toaster Oven that all of her troubles and all of her problems, that you will show her a sign of why those troubles are there, Lord, because we know that you will not make us suffer without understanding that you are doing it for a purpose, Lord. Thank you so very much for you and allowing us all to be praying for Toaster Oven. And I also want to pray for all of the unsaid prayers that were done tonight, Lord. Thank you so much for answering in your own way those prayers as well, Lord. You are an amazing God, and we all love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, everyone, thank you so much for being a part of this. I think I want to end it with reading an awesome prayer, a poem that was mentioned during this prayer hour, and I think it really fits perfectly. Footprints is the poem. There was a man who had a dream, and he reviewed the footprints he had taken in his life. He looked down and noticed that all over the mountains and difficult places that he had traveled, there was one set of footprints. But over the plains and down the hills, there were two sets of footprints, as if someone had walked by his side. He turned to the Lord and said, "There is something I don't understand. Why is it that down the hills and over the smooth and easy places you have walked by my side, but here over the rough and difficult places you have walked alone? For I see in those areas there are only one set of footprints." The Lord turned to the man and said, "It was while your life was easy that I walked along your side. But here, where the walking was hard and the paths were difficult, was the time you needed me most. And there is where I carried you." Wow, very awesome poem, and it fits tonight. Toaster Oven, you are always going to be in my prayers. And sometimes you'll see solutions, people wanting to give you solutions. If you are able to take those solutions, take them. If not, do understand that we are all behind you and wanting to pray for you. You are an awesome human being. Know that. And for those of you who feel guilty, that you think your life is amazing, and it very well be amazing, but I give you guys so much credit for being here during your amazing life. Why? Because you're choosing to pray for those who are in need. Many people who are self-centered, who believe that their life is good and all life is grand, wouldn't be here praying for those who are in need. So it is in my opinion that you do not need to feel guilty, because your life is good. You're here helping the suffering by praying for them. And I give you guys kudos for that. Thank you. Wow, what a powerful hour. I want to say thank you for everyone who was here. I think you're all amazing. I think we had a record-breaking 10 or 11 people in this room. And I only giggled because, you know what? It's 11 amazing folks who really want to be here. 11 people who were listening silently. Some of you were listening silently. That's completely okay. I don't need you to say anything. I'm just glad that you're here. And those who did speak up, thank you. Thank you for showing the power of prayer and the power of knowing that if somebody speaks up and they need prayer, some of you are there showing that their prayer is heard and seen. So thank you so much. I could ramble on, but I'm going to end it with this. Remember, people are not evil. Let me scratch that. I've learned today that some might be. Many people are not evil like we want them to be. They just have evil in them. And if that's true, God says we pray for them. We pray for those who are choosing to be evil, choosing to do evil acts, choosing to do wrong things in their lives that may or may not be affecting others in the world. It is up to us to be able to pray for them and pray for their souls, and that they will turn around and be a better soul for humankind. I think it's great that we point out the evil, because other people may not know what's going on and they need to be protected. Absolutely believe in that. But just remember, don't thrive in it. Don't be happy that you had to do it. Don't giggle about it. Just share with others the evilness that is going on, so that way they can protect in the way they need to be protected in their own minds. And then again, continue to pray for the individual who is choosing to be evil. I love you, each and every single one of you. And I am so, so thankful that you came. I don't think we have a midweek teaching this week because of Easter Sunday or Easter week. So I look forward to seeing you guys all again on Sunday morning at 8 a.m. Mountain Time. And then again, of course, 8 p.m. Mountain Time that Sunday evening. God bless you all. And those who just have a better, higher power, doesn't matter if you have a God in your whole life, doesn't matter if you Mother Nature in your life, doesn't matter if you have Buddha in your life. What matters is you're here praying how you believe. Thank you so, so much for being here. Till next time, you all have a beautiful, wonderful day. Bye now.